The Galaxy Note 10 Plus versus the iPhone XS Max. It's a battle between two of the largest, most expensive phones money can buy. But what do you really get for that $1,100 starting price? At this level, the basics are covered well by both. But does Samsung's newer, flashier, S Pen-toting device actually offer you more? I'm Corey Gaskin with Digital Trends. Let's dive in and find out. These are top-tier devices, and whether you're putting them through intense work or play, you're going to get top-level performance from both. Though Apple's A12 Bionic chip has consistently performed better than the Snapdragon 855 found in the Note 10 Plus. But the Note 10 Plus also has 12 gigabytes of RAM, which is massive. Still, it's kind of hard to beat iPhone's polish and fluidity, so we might give a slight edge to the iPhone there, but truly it's going to be hard to tell a difference in day-to-day performance. In terms of powering these beasts, the Note 10 Plus has 1,000 mAh more battery capacity than the iPhone XS Max, though both of these should give you about a day's usage. The Note 10 Plus may slightly edge out the XS Max in this area, but it's going to be hard to tell without some further testing. The Note 10 Plus also supports faster wired and wireless charging capabilities, with a 25-watt charger out of the box, which charges faster than the 5-watt charger included with the iPhone XS Max. The Note 10 Plus also supports 45-watt charging, which Samsung says can charge from 0 to 70% in 30 minutes. Apple also says you can use an 18-watt charger to charge the iPhone XS Max from 0 to 50% in about 30 minutes. But without that, the 5-watt charger that comes in box takes about 3.5 hours to charge from 0 to 100. For the faster bundled in-box charging, we're gonna go with the Samsung Galaxy Note 10 Plus on this one. We'll just get it out of the way right now. The headphone jack is gone from the Samsung Galaxy Note 10 Plus, joining the iPhone XS with the ranks of those that no longer care about 3.5mm jacks. They're also almost the same exact size and thinness, but the Galaxy Note 10 Plus is just a few millimeters taller than the XS Max, despite the fact that it fits nearly a half inch more screen real estate inside of that frame, making a 90% screen to body ratio compared to 85% on the XS Max. Whether you prefer the notch or the hole punch camera is really up to personal preference. The Note 10 uses aluminum while the iPhone employs stainless steel. Samsung says they're using Gorilla Glass 6, while Apple is a little bit more cagey with their answer, saying only that they use durable glass, which may very well be the same thing. Less bezels do mean less protection though, so the XS Max may be slightly more durable, especially since its edges don't curve as much. You should expect both of these phones to shatter from nasty drops, so put a case on these expensive devices. But we're gonna give the edge to the Note 10 Plus for its more futuristic, sleek, and beautiful design, especially in that Aura Glow color. At this price point, you should expect some of the best screen technology, and that's what you're getting with Samsung's Dynamic AMOLED and Apple's OLED displays. The Note 10 Plus has a slightly higher screen resolution and pixel density over the XS Max, so it will appear sharper, as well as being 0.3 inches bigger at 6.8 inches versus 6.5. DisplayMate said the Galaxy S10 was the most accurate screen they'd ever tested, and the Note 10 Plus uses the same dynamic AMOLED display technology. So the Note 10 Plus may have an edge here, but the iPhone's True Tone display and 120Hz touch sensing rate may be more noticeable advantages for the average user. We'll still give the edge to Samsung here for the higher screen to body ratio, pixel density, and better color accuracy. The battle between top tier cameras is always a good one. But this time we're only looking at two cameras from Apple and three from Samsung, plus a time of flight sensor for better portrait shots and live focus. The time of flight sensor assists the Note 10 in getting better depth information for portrait videos and photos. The XS Max already does a pretty solid job with portrait photos, and we're not likely to miss portrait video from the XS Max much. Both the main and telephoto cameras on both of these phones use 12 megapixel sensors with very similar apertures. Samsung does add variable aperture though, which we've seen on the S10 Plus give a bit of an edge over the XS in low light, so we expect very similar results on the Note 10 Plus. Speaking of the front-facing cameras, we have 7 megapixels on the XS Max and 10 megapixels on the Note 10 Plus. Both should take pretty good selfies, but we're gonna give the edge overall to the Note 10 Plus for its more versatile camera setups. When it comes to the user interface, we're looking at Samsung One UI based on Android Pie versus iOS 12 on the XS Max. In terms of support, Samsung's been a little bit late when it comes to getting updates around, but you should expect around 2 years of updates for any flagship device. You should probably expect the Android Q update around January of 2020. On the other hand, the iPhone XS Max can expect between 4 and 5 years of major OS updates, and you're gonna get iOS 13 the day it releases. Android versus iOS is its own stylistic and philosophical debate to be had, but Android's biggest challenge is to match the polish and support that iOS delivers. For this round, we're gonna go with the iPhone XS Max. At first glance, the Note 10 is going to appear to have more special features, especially with the S Pen, which now adds support for changing camera modes, gesture controls, and also transcribing notes to Word docs. You also now have Samsung DeX, which can be triggered by simply plugging in a USB cable to your Note 10 and plugging it into a Mac or PC device. Samsung also expands its integrations with Microsoft on the Note 10 Plus, introducing the ability to receive text messages, notifications, and soon phone calls from your PC through your Galaxy Note 10 device. Samsung is also promising a new feature called Galaxy Play Link, which allows you to stream PC games from your computer directly to your Note 10 device and play them on the go. This will likely be a better feature for the 5G model, since it's going to depend solely on your connection and device capabilities. The more expensive 5G Note 10 Plus is an option, but it isn't really an option for anybody who doesn't actually have 5G coverage, which is most people in the USA. Which is a good reason why Apple hasn't made a 5G iPhone yet. Plus, the seamlessness of handoff between iPhones and Macs is pretty hard to beat, especially when all of these features, text, notifications, and phone calls are already supported currently. And at the end of the day, taking handwritten notes on a phone is still a pretty niche desire. For the better ecosystem and support, we're gonna go with the iPhone XS Max on this one. They're both very expensive devices, starting at $1,100. You can likely find the XS Max for a little bit less than that though, considering that the new iPhone is right around the corner. It is worth noting that at the $1,100 starting price, the iPhone XS gets 64GB of storage, while the Samsung Galaxy Note 10 Plus starts at 256, with the option for a microSD card of up to 1TB more. And Apple clearly doesn't offer microSD card expansion. It's a tight race between these expensive titans, but we're gonna give the win to the Samsung Galaxy Note 10 Plus for its better storage options, more versatile camera, and bigger, faster charging battery. All of these combined should make the Note 10 Plus the better pick if you want the best of the best right now. Plus, the S Pen adds some pretty cool new tricks as well. But if you're sticking with iOS, the iPhone XS Max is the best that you can do right now.